Last time we set out the formalism for how to do a double integral over a general region. This time we're going to do a few examples. So our first example, our region is the inside of the unit disk, or actually the top half of the unit disk. So this is actually, and the function we're going to integrate is x squared y. So this is actually a type 1 region. See, the bottom of the region is the line y equals 0. That's the x-axis. The top of the region is the top half of the circle. And the circle we know is x squared plus y squared equals 1. And that means that y is the square root of 1 minus x squared. So we're looking for all is the region between the curve y equals square root of 1 minus x squared and y equals 0 between a equals negative 1 and b equals 1. So this is a type 1 region. In terms of our earlier notation, g of x is 0, h of x is the square root of 1 minus x squared, and so that means that to write the double integral of x squared y over our region, we first integrate dy from g of x to h of x, and then we integrate that from negative 1 to 1. The limits of integration on y are functions of x. In this case, it happens to be a constant function, but still in principle it's a function. The limits of integration on x are numbers. So let's do that first integral. The integral of x squared y dy, you treat x just like a constant. So that's x squared y squared over 2. So we have to plug in what happens. X squared y squared over 2 when y equals root 1 minus x squared and 1 y equals 0. When y is root 1 minus x squared, y squared is 1 minus x squared. When y equals 0, well, y squared is 0. So this gives us x squared times 1 minus x squared over 2. And then integrating that from negative 1 to 1 is easy. We multiply it out, get x squared minus x to the fourth over 2. The integral of that is x cubed over 3 over 6 minus x to the fifth over 10. Evaluate that between 1 and minus 1. You just plug in the numbers, and out pops 2 fifteenths. So the big ideas are draw a picture, figure out what the lower limit is, what the upper limit is. That tells you what y goes from. It goes from 0 to root 1 minus x squared. Figure out where the leftmost column is. Well, the leftmost column is at negative 1. The rightmost column is at 1. So the limits of integration on x are negative 1 to 1. And then the rest is mechanical. Okay, now that we've done a type 1 region, let's do a type 2 region. So this time, we want to integrate 4x e to the 2y over a region bounded by the x-axis, the y-axis, the line y equals 2, and the curve y equals natural log of x. So, first thing to do is draw a picture. We're bounded by the x-axis, the y-axis, the line y equals 2, and the curve y equals natural log of x. Now, if you wanted to think of this as a type 1 region, you'd have a mess, because over here you're going between 0 and 2, and over here you're going between natural log of x and 2. I guess you could break it up into two pieces and treat each piece as a type 1 region, but it's easier to treat the whole thing as a type 2 region. So instead of arranging columns, you want to figure out what happens in each row. So for each value of y, you want to say what is happening across the row, get the entire row, and then add the rows together. Now, for the row, you have to say, what's the smallest value of x? Well, that's 0. What's the biggest value of x? Well, that's this curve. Except we've written it as y as a function of x. You have to use inverse functions to write that as x as a function of y. So for each value of y, x goes from 0 to e to the y. So our integral is going to involve going x goes from 0 to e to the y. And then the leftmost column was at y equals 0. Sorry, the bottom, not the leftmost. The lowest row is at y equals 0. The highest row is at y equals 2. So y goes from 0 to 2. The inner integral is telling you what is happening in a single row. The outer integral is putting all the rows together. Okay, now we integrate 4x e to the 2y dx. Well, e to the 2y is treated as a constant because x is our variable. This is for a particular value of y. What's the integral of 4x dx? 2x squared. So we have 2x squared e to the 2y, and we evaluate that at 0 and e to the y, and that gives us 2 e to the 4y. And then we integrate that from 0 to 2, and that gives 1 half e to the 4y at 0 and at 2, so that's e to the 8th minus 1 all over 2.